to meet an engineer who helps artificial intelligence be, well, more intelligent. Nabil has the story.
The definition of artificial intelligence, or AI, is when you teach a machine to think for itself. Machines can learn how to identify anything from objects to actions to people. But how do you teach a machine? To find out, I'm headed to Atlanta, Georgia, to meet with Dr. Nashley Cephas, who is an expert in machine learning and has invented some of the most cutting-edge AI there is.
I was first inspired to go into engineering when I was in the eighth grade. My science teacher pulled me to the side and said, "You really should consider going to this summer engineering camp." I remember going to that camp and remembering my whole life changing, finding out about computer engineering.
Nashley's love for computing led her to invent an app where you can point your phone at an object and the AI will tell you exactly what that object is and how to get it for yourself.
Do this coat rack. Yeah, coat rack. Oh, wait, no. Do this pot with the plant in it. Wait, do the plant itself, the dirt. Oh, do the dirt, wait.
Let's just bypass the next 10 minutes of me looking at every office supply I can find and we'll start at the beginning.
Thank you so much for meeting with me, Dr. Nashley Cephas. You made an incredible app, which clearly I don't know how to use. Could you tell me about it?
The team and I first started at a startup company called ParkPick, and we wanted to develop technology that would do visual search for replacement parts. So for example, you're looking for a screw or a nut or a bolt or a washer, and you're wanting to find that part that you're missing, or maybe your dog ate it, or you dropped it down the drain, who knows? So, in order to find that part, usually you would take it to some parts store and try to get someone to help you find it. Well, we thought, instead of having to do all that, instead of trying to search for something online that you don't even know what it's called, we would allow you to take a picture of it, and we would not only measure it, but tell you what the part is and where you can buy the part.
So is ParkPick a form of AI?
A lot of people think of AI as any way to make computers and technology think, see, speak, act like a human, or even better than a human. And AI uses machine learning at its core, which involves lots and lots of data and finding patterns in that data. Once we find those patterns, we now know how to recognize other things that have similar patterns.
So that it can do it on its own.
Exactly. I have a video I can show you.
Oh yeah, sure.
So what type of hairstyle are you looking for? What type of drive type are you looking for? Once you select those attributes about it, we show now the measurements, like the length, the diameter, and we show your screw is actually the first one in the list.
Wow, that's awesome. So you can do all of that just by taking a picture of it?
Yes.
Apps that use AI, like this one, obviously make life a lot easier. And Dr. Cephas continues to work hard to make sure that the data utilized in her app does not come back with a biased result.
For example, if we're building a product that will identify a person, we want to make sure that we've trained our AI models on lots of different types of people, different types of ages, different ethnicities, different skin colors, different genders. And so all of this comes into account when we're trying to recognize something we haven't seen before in the wild. My math teacher used to always say, when we were using the calculator, that doesn't guarantee the right answer just because you're using a tool. Garbage in, garbage out. So good data in, quality data, adequate data that represents a diverse group of people creates a good quality product.
As the use of artificial intelligence continues to grow, so do the challenges, especially when it comes to eliminating bias. But with the vigilance of pioneers like Dr. Nashley Cephas, the future of AI is definitely in good hands.